This figure shows a unit volume of porous media, the so-called elemental control volume, Qx, Qy, and Qz are the volume flux densities, specific discharges, in meter per day into the elemental control volume in the perpendicular x, y, and z directions. dqx dx is the rate in which qx changes with x. By multiplying this rate of change with the section delta x, where the change takes place, we obtain the total change over this section in meter per day. The same reasoning is applied in the y and z direction. The inflow is given by this equation. Q in cubic meter per day equals Qx times the area delta y delta z perpendicular to the groundwater flow in the x direction, plus Qy times the perpendicular surface delta x delta z, plus Qz times the perpendicular surface delta x delta y. The outflow from the elemental control volume Q out equals Qx plus the total change dQx dx times delta x in the x direction, and this times the area delta y delta z perpendicular to the groundwater flow in the x direction, etc. for the y and z direction. The net inflow, Q in minus Q out, is then as shown below. Here we have the equation for the net inflow again. Stationary or steady state flow occurs when at any point in a flow field, the magnitude and direction of the flow velocity are constant with time. dv dt equals zero. For this steady flow, continuity then tells us that the net inflow equals the change of storage, which is zero. Dividing both sides of the equation by delta x, delta y, delta z, the continuity equation can be rewritten as shown below. Darcy's law can be written as shown here. The volume flux density or specific discharge in the x direction equals minus kx, the saturated hydraulic conductivity in the x direction, times the hydraulic gradient dH dx in the x direction. H is the hydraulic head. And likewise for the y and z directions. When we insert these equations of Darcy's law for Qx, Qy, and Qz in the continuity equation, we get this equation as shown below. Here we have the last equation again. For a homogeneous isotropic medium, the saturated hydraulic conductivities Kx, Ky, and Kz are constant and equal to each other. Dividing both sides of the equation by the saturated hydraulic conductivity delivers the following equation for steady state flow through a homogeneous isotropic medium, the so-called Laplace equation as shown here. The equation is named after Pierre-Simon Marquis de Laplace, a French scholar and polymath. Thus, the Laplace equation is derived by combining continuity, or the water balance equation, as related to the mass balance equation, with Darcy's law, the equation of water movement, for an elemental control volume. Combining these two equations, continuity and Darcy's law, is standard practice in groundwater hydrology. We will see in other lectures that the Laplace equation for steady groundwater flow in an aquifer between two parallel fully penetrating canals, canals incised to the top of a lower impermeable layer, with different constant water levels, as shown in these two figures, reduces to the following so-called Laplacians: d squared h dx squared equals 0 for confined groundwater, and d squared h squared dx squared equals 0 for unconfined groundwater. When we integrate this first equation, a second derivative, we get dh dx equals c1. And when we integrate this again, we get the equation h equals c1x plus c2, which describes the linear distribution of h, the hydraulic heads, for this confined aquifer. C1 and c2 are constants that can be determined by inserting the left and right boundary conditions of this specific confined groundwater flow case. Same for an unconfined aquifer. When we integrate this second derivative, we get dh squared dx equals c1. And when we integrate this yet another time, we get h squared equals c1x plus c2, which describes the parabolic distribution of h, the hydraulic heads, for this unconfined or phreatic aquifer. Also here, c1 and c2 are constants that can be determined by inserting the left and right boundary conditions. Now, for this specific unconfined groundwater flow case, analytical equations can be established for both stationary groundwater flow cases and non-stationary groundwater flow cases. Non-stationary is also called transient. Transient flow, unsteady or non-steady flow, occurs when at any point in a flow field, the magnitude or direction of the flow velocity changes with time. dv dt is not equal to zero. Examples of transient groundwater flow are when an open water level is suddenly lowered or raised, or when pumping of a groundwater well starts or ends, thus when there is no steady state. For instance, the general flow equation for radial symmetric unconfined groundwater flow in a homogeneous and isotropic medium is the Boussinesq equation as shown below. The Boussinesq equation, named after Joseph Valentin Boussinesq, a French mathematician and physicist, a linearized form is shown here, includes both the change of hydraulic head in time, dH dt, and Sy, the specific yield. The specific yield is a measure of the volume of water per volume of porous material released by the forces of gravity in response to a decline of the water table. D bar here is the average aquifer depth, K of course the saturated hydraulic conductivity, and Kd, K times the aquifer depth D, is called the transmissivity or transmissibility of the aquifer.